Assalamu alaikum, welcome to Time's Up Ummah. Today's first news update is coming from Afghanistan, where huge clashes held between Afghan security forces and the Taliban. And sources have said once again the three districts have fallen to the Taliban, and at least 20 people have been killed, including civilians. The three main districts have fallen to the Taliban during this period, and lawmakers have said in parliament that four districts in the province have fallen to the Taliban in just the past week. They also said the Afghan government have control of only one center in the province, where unidentified gunmen have killed five police workers and wounded four others. President Ashraf Ghani led meetings over the past 3 days to address the fragile security situation, but during this period, 10 districts have fell to the Taliban. According to the reports, in Sariful province, the center of Gospandi and Samcharak districts have fallen to the Taliban. A resident of Sariful has said the war has reached the main gates of the city. Balkh district is also under the threat. We are very concerned. We appeal to the government to focus on the Sariful province, said Muhammad Taqi, a resident in the Sariful. The Taliban took over Kohistanat district and Sariful province in a few years ago. What should the people expect from the approach? The people think there might be a deal behind the scenes. They think that the government in a sense wants to arm the Taliban and give territory to the Taliban, a MP Said Hayatullah Alimi said. There were Taliban conquering the districts daily, and they have took control of yet over 30 districts across the country. The brutal violence in the country has still continued, and Taliban attempts to take control of many districts as soon as possible. The reports also saying hundreds of the Afghan security forces have surrendered to the Taliban. Pawad Aman has said the present situation will not continue in this shape. The Afghan security forces will be deployed in all those areas where the Taliban have infiltrated and conducted attacks against the people. The security forces will prevent attacks by the Taliban. The Afghan government is now at its weak position, and the experts saying the Taliban will take over the big provinces soon. Their viewers, Pakistan has struggled to bring both sides to the peace and calm the unrest in the Afghanistan, but both sides have some differences, and until the Taliban took even Kabul, they are not ready for a political settlement. Now the Turkey has said, we will be the only reliable country that will bring peace to Afghanistan. The Turkish president now struggling to remain its forces in the Kabul airport. Today's second news update is coming from China, where China flew 28 aircrafts towards the self-ruled island of Taiwan, which was a clear violation of the Taiwan airspace. Dear viewers, the display was the largest since China started sending fighter jets towards Taiwan. The Taiwan's Air Force deployed its combat air patrol force in response and monitored the situation in the southwestern part of the island's air defense identification zone with its air defense system. It added that the jets included various types of fighter jets, including 14 J-16 and 6 J-11 planes, as well as the bombers. Dear viewers, the China's act comes as the G7 meeting issued a statement about the China and the Taiwan issue, it calling for a peaceful resolution of the Taiwan issue because it is so important for the peace and stability. Dear viewers, the United States have now its clear focus on the China, and they have made it their goal to counter China as China growing on its economic side, which becoming a threat for the United States. And the China's show was also a message to the United States and all Western powers. And here you should also know that a spokesman for the China Foreign Ministry has said the G7 was deliberately interfering in China's internal affairs. He added that China's determination to safeguard national sovereignty, security, and development interests is unwavering. Dear viewers, China and Taiwan split in two countries after civil war in 1949, but China still considered Taiwan as a part of the Chinese territory. Dear viewers, since the election of President Tsai Ing-wen in 2016, China has increased diplomatic and military pressure on the government over the refusal to agree to China's insistence that the island be considered a part of the Chinese territory. Now China considers Taiwan as its part, and the United States wants to help Taiwan for its security. The United States has its own interest with Taiwan, and especially the United States doing that because it wants to counter the China. And China has now sent a message to the United States and the G7 countries that we will do what we want. Today's third news update is coming from Pakistan and Russia, where the Pakistani and Russian foreign ministers have talked on a phone call and have agreed to struggle for a peace in Afghanistan as violence intensified in Afghanistan. Dear viewers, in April, the Russian foreign minister visited Pakistan to strengthen ties and work together for a bright future. Hopes of a political settlement of the Afghan conflict are dimming with United States forces pulling out of the war-ravaged country at a much faster pace than initially expected. According According to the United States Central Command, more than 50% of the pullout process, which began on May 1st, has been completed. But the main problem here is, if the United States pull its forces out of Afghanistan without a political settlement, there are high chances of a brutal civil war in Afghanistan, and it will affect the security of all neighboring countries, especially Pakistan, which faced it previously. Dear viewers, President Biden had initially announced that the withdrawal would be completed by September 11 to coincide with the 20th anniversary of the 9/11 incident that led to the United States attack on Afghanistan. However, from the face of the retrograde mission, it looks the process could be completed much earlier. And now Pakistan and Russia have agreed to struggle for a political settlement which is needed in Afghanistan. During Lavrov's trip, both sides had agreed to further facilitate the warring Afghan groups and reaching a politically negotiated agreement. Russia had planned to convene a meeting of the Moscow format involving Afghanistan's neighbors and other important countries of the region to facilitate the intra-Afghan negotiations that appear to have stalled, but it has happened so far. Dear viewers, Moscow have also hosted an intra-Afghan dialogue, but there were no meaningful consequences of it. And now Turkey also preparing to hold an Afghan peace conference, but there are some issues with both warring sides, at which they had not agreed to attend the meeting. The Taliban now thinks that we can take control of many areas by using the power. And Taliban has also previously said there are no meaningful results of talks that had healed before, and Afghan government is not ready for any compromises. So overall, the situation is unstable, and Pakistan and Russia will have especially to seriously work for it. Dear viewers, now there can be happened anything, and maybe the Taliban start takeover of big areas. Dear viewers, if you want to watch top news of the day, please subscribe Times of Ummah.